So I'm sitting here in the middle of what we call the North Pole Dome. It's kind of a funny name to be right in the middle of the Australian desert, but I think it's a sort of Australian larrikinism of just working in extremely hot environments. I know, mate, it's like the North Pole. But this is quite a unique environment because rocks of great age are incredibly well preserved. And these rocks just behind me here, you can still see the direction that the water flowed over the ancient surface almost 3.49 billion years ago. And that's a profound experience to see something we can recognize in the very early Earth, only a billion years after it was formed. And that's what makes this place so special. And this particular horizon is, we've given it a name called the Dresser Formation. It's just a unit of rocks that's very particular and distinctive in terms of its textures and its compositions. And we've been able to extract material from these rocks and date them very precisely with tiny mineral grains, and we get a very nice age from that. And as geologists then, we walk over the fields and over these hills looking at how the rocks change under our feet, always looking for relationships about way up, for evidence for faulting, something that may have modified the succession. But the really nice thing here is that there are just enough layers that we can date and enough textures in the rocks to ensure that we're looking at a package that is coherent through time. And as we go up through the different layers, we get progressively younger age dates, and we get changes not only in the textures of the rocks, but in the composition of the rocks as we go up. It's constantly changing and evolving. And that change gives us an idea about how crust is formed in this very early period of Earth history, and how that compares with and or differs to modern geology. And that, for me, has been one of the great joys of working in this environment, is understanding how early Earth worked. And as we go through this area of tilted rocks, we can recognize units that we see in other panels of tilted rocks around this region. And we can combine them and say that they are a single stratigraphic unit, but different from other stratigraphic units. So this Dresser Formation, which I said is about 3490 million years, is texturally and compositionally distinct from the Marble Bar Chert, which we've also seen on this trip. And we have very nice dating evidence to support it being a different stratigraphic unit. And with that change in texture, we can also infer a different environment, where the Marble Bar Chert has very fine layering, which we used to say was probably deposited in deep water, whereas here we have a lot of irregular layering with ripples that we can still identify as being the result of sandstone moving around in an ancient beach environment. We never see these textures in the Marble Bar Chert, and we never see the red jaspolitic chert of Marble Bar in these rocks. So that allows us to identify different parts of the picture and see how it changed through time.